Alright folks, this is video number 3 in a selection I'm doing on a program entitled Mixed in Key. Now what I've done, as I said in video 2, I've burnt a CD, but I've made a duplicate. So in other words, I've got two exact same CDs. And what I've done, I've just sort of bunged that information on a piece of paper. Basically, the information is telling me which track is in which key. Look to the side of the video and you can see that as well. Now what I can do then, if I've got an exact copy of each CD, what I've actually done is I've tried to make sure that track 1 is a certain key, track 2 is a key that can follow track 1, track 3 of course is a key that can follow track 2, track 4 is a key that can follow track 3. So in essence, what I can actually do then when I'm constructing a set, I can go from this CDJ, which is track 1, onto this one, which will be track 2, onto this one, which will be track 3, track 4, track 5, 6, etc. Okay, so it'll give you a general sort of idea. Like I said, look to the side of the video. Now again, what we've done, the keys I'm actually using, we've got 10A, 11A and 12A. So have a look at that wheel, have a look to the side, and you will actually see the track names and the keys, the appropriate keys. Now, shall I plug the... I'll tell you what, I'll plug the cable into the side of the camera so you get better audio. So just hold tight, I'll just pause it for a second. Actually, and very quickly as well, if you see me do that, I'm just wanging the actual CD forward a little bit. Otherwise, we'll end up spending most of the actual video just listening to beats. So I'm going to have to try and get into the middle of the track. Okay, here we go.
Oh shit.
So there you go, a bit of a set in a way where it's actually constructed. Not only it's beat matched, but it's key matched as well. All right, now fair enough, we sort of bung those tracks in. Okay, getting it in beat is one thing, getting it in key is another thing, but then also one very important factor that will change the way you make a set, or will take you to the next level, will make you be a better DJ, and that of course is to actually construct the set. It's all well and good getting it beat matched. It's fantastic getting it beat matched and in key, but to get you that one step higher, it's all about construction as well. Now, anyone can, well, when I say anyone, it's difficult to, let's say, get beat matched. It's difficult to keep things in key, to keep the continuity and the flow of the actual mix you're trying to put together. But only you can actually choose the tracks to go in with each other to get an almost a binding mix that sounds good, and it's the actual construction is there. And that is what takes a DJ from a good DJ to a fantastic DJ, and sadly that's something that only you can actually do. You've got to look at your tracks and you've got to go through them and think, yeah, that will go with that, because they work really well together. Not only will they be beat matched, not only will they will actually sound well where the key's concerned, but they will also feel right together. That's very important. So another video for you. Practice and enjoy.